tax fraud convict who was slapped with a 5-year sentence for illegally voting in 2016 presidential election is denied a retrial. A Texas woman who was sentenced to 5 years in prison in March for casting a ballot in the 2016 presidential election while ineligible to vote has been denied a new trial. Crystal Mason, a 43-year-old tax fraud convict from Rendon, Texas, voted in the 2016 election while on supervised release, unaware that she was ineligible under a state law that says felons are only allowed to vote after they have fully completed their sentence. Mason was slapped with a hefty 5-year prison sentence in March of this year, and on Monday the same judge denied her request for a new trial. The mother of two says she plans to challenge the decision. "Right now, I'm very overwhelmed with all this. Everything is a shock, you know? Everything," Mason told CBS This Week. Mason, a tax preparer, pleaded guilty to tax fraud in 2011 and was sentenced to 5 years in federal prison followed by 3 years of supervised release. Shortly after she was released from prison in 2016, her mother convinced her to go vote in the presidential election, a decision that she now regrets. "I'm wishing that I never voted. That's how I'm wishing. I'm wishing that I never ever went up there to vote." At the polling place, Mason was required to sign an affidavit which lists requirements for voting, including that convicted felons can have their voting privileges restored after fully completing their sentences. Mason said she didn't thoroughly read the affidavit because the election worker had been helping her fill the form out. Election workers soon discovered that she was a convicted felon and she was arrested in February for voter fraud. During her trial testimony, Mason said that no one had told her she had to wait until her supervised release was over before she could vote. "She was never told that she couldn't vote, and she voted in good faith," Mason's lawyer Jay Rohr in St. John said in court. "Why would she risk going back to prison for something that is not going to change her life?" Judge Ruben Gonzalez handed down a 5-year prison sentence in March and denied Mason's request for a retrial this week. She is now planning to file an appeal. "One of the things that we are going to complain to the appellate court is that this law really isn't clear," Mason's defense attorney Allison Grinter said after the request for a retrial was denied. Mason's defense team also says that the sentence is far too strict, citing a similar case in Iowa in which a woman was only sentenced to 2 years on probation.